Virgo, we're getting ready to do your love reading. Love reading for Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising. And Venus, let's see for Virgo. Virgo, here you are in your own reading. Look at that Knight of Pentacles energy. You look like you're very content. You're just sort of moving ahead. You're doing the things that you need to do. You feel very calm, very cool, collected. You know what direction you're headed in. You're moving slowly. It does look like in the recent past, you probably have moved away from somebody. You've left somebody behind. You know, you're not in a hurry though. You're really looking at being very balanced. That's Libra energy, very critical in terms of what you want, really thinking about it. We get the Queen of Swords energy, and this is an energy that says, I want the truth, the whole truth. I want balance. I want something that is really beneficial in my life. I don't want anything that is not going to serve me in my life. That's how you feel right now, Virgo. So let's see what the energy is. How is the world viewing Virgo right now? How is Virgo presenting themselves? Well, you are working hard, but you know, you're cautious. What I get is that you have a lot of fire in your belly for something. I'm getting that, you know, you're very determined to get the kind of relationship you want. You are seeking happiness and you want somebody who's going to have equal give and take with you. You definitely have a fire in your belly for someone that it appears that you know this person. It doesn't look like it would be a brand new love. But what we're seeing here is that you have this very fiery energy for an adventure with someone. You're walking towards them, but you're not in a rush. So let's see what the hidden energy is here in this reading. What is hidden for our Virgo friends? Somebody left you feeling underwater. I'm getting that whoever you left behind, it looks as though you feel this very Piscean sort of confusion, not really sure what happened. You just don't know what you don't know. Let's see what the advice from Spirit is for you, Virgo. Let's see. Ooh, stay cool, calm, collected. Stay very intellectual. Your messages are going to come to you through your intuition, through your logic, through your ability to just discern the truth, because the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords, and you know, it's telling us that you have a very fine understanding of what is going on around you. You don't know all the details yet. So what is the outcome for you this week in your love life? Oh, Ten of Cups, Virgo, didn't see that coming. Look at that energy. So it does look like you were waiting here. This is your ships have come in. But Ten of Cups energy, that is happily ever after energy. Pisces energy. So let's go ahead and clarify this and see what your person is feeling about the energy between the two of you. So what is going on with, let's clarify your feelings first. Why is Virgo, why do we have the Knight of Pentacles energy for Virgo? Okay, walking towards your happiness twice. You're walking towards your happiness twice. So you definitely, there's a strong Leo energy. So you may be attracted to this King of Wands. You may have might have Leo energy in your chart somewhere, but you are definitely looking for happiness. Somebody who really can take control, or, you know, really be super like go-getter, you know, go get them in the reading. You want someone who's going to pursue you and be about passion. You want somebody who's very stable, who's very nurturing. The Moon card says you are following your intuition. You're looking at things from a different perspective. You just don't want to hear anything that isn't honest. So it does look as though somebody in the past has left you sort of blindsided and you really don't know what's going on. You are waiting for answers. You're looking at things from a different perspective. But the Nine of Swords is you have some remorse and regret about something that was said or done. Let's get some more clarification on that. The Hermit card. There you are, Virgo, looking for answers. The Two of Wands. You had plans with somebody that did not work out. Seven of Cups. They really didn't tell you what was going on. Page of Pentacles. there's an offer coming in, Three of Coins, maybe somebody you worked with, and the Ten of Coins. So there's something about this person, Virgo, that you feel very much you will get to know the truth. You feel as though you have to work with them again. I'm getting this, you know, this Ten of Coins is a legacy marriage. We have your outcome as a Ten of Cups. So it's like you're waiting to see this person and you don't really know why they have not been communicating with you. And it's getting to you. It doesn't look like it makes you very happy. So let's see why we have the Ten of, well, let's look at the Six of Coins. Why do we have the Six of Coins here for Virgo? Why is the Six of Coins here for Virgo? Okay. The Death card. So somebody that you worked with seems to have walked away without really telling you what was going on. The Four of Pentacles, you're still holding out hope for this person, Virgo. Again, I do think this person might be a fire sign energy. Why is the Death card here, Spirit? Why is the Death card here? Wheel of Fortune turn. The timing wasn't right to move forward. Queen of Swords. Your person made a logical decision, as have you. The Queen of Wands with the King of Wands. The Queen of Swords with the King of Swords. The two of you are very well matched. The Nine of Wands here with the Three of Wands says that you still have fire in your belly. Nine of Wands, Nine of Wands. You still want to see each other. So it looks like you're in separation, but more, you know, it looks like things have been sort of just left to sort of be adrift, like you're a boat adrift in the water. So let's see why we have, why are you hanging out here? Why is a Hanged Man here? Why is a Hanged Man here? King of Wands. Okay. King of Wands twice now. Queen of Wands once. Okay. Nine of Pentacles. Nine of Pentacles energy with a Knight of Pentacles, a Queen of Pentacles. There's a lot of practical energy here. It really looks like both of you have missed each other. Both of you really didn't talk about this. It's like there was a separation that you didn't talk about. A new beginning, though, for both of you. You really love each other. After the Eight of Cups, a new beginning that somebody walked away from or hasn't. That is weird. Okay. It's not often that you have somebody walking towards a new beginning and somebody's still walking away. We have Eight of Cups, Eight of Cups. We need to clarify that. What is going on with this Eight of Cups energy? What is going on with this Eight of Cups energy, Spirit? What is going on with the Eight of Cups energy? What has happened to cause this walk away? Anxiety. There's a lot of anxiety here. Why is there anxiety? There's appreciation. Interesting. Oh my gosh, a storm warning. A thinking woman. Oh, there was, somehow there was a massive miscommunication. Whatever it is, somebody said to another that somehow it went unaddressed. You had some sort of conversation in which both of you thought you were on the same page. You thought everything was okay. But I'm getting that there was a massive miscommunication between you and this person. Yeah, woman holding a heart. So it looks like the feminine said something to the masculine to make them feel as though the relationship was over or that they were walking away. There's a storm. Woman, this, you know, thinking woman energy is here. So Virgo, let's see what the masculine, let's look at the masculine energy here. Whoever the masculine is, okay, so let's get this deck to clarify masculine energy here because there's a lot of feminine energy. So what is the masculine energy here? Why is this Virgo Knight of Wands masculine energy walking towards our happiness? Clarify this, please, Virgo. Five of Cups. Okay, so Virgo, you're walking in, or the masculine energy is walking in here. I feel in a very thoughtful way to make an apology. The Five of Cups, but let's see. The Wheel of Fortune, the timing isn't right. So what is, why is the Five of Cups here? Aha, there we go. Okay. So it doesn't look like it's going to happen immediately, but I'm getting that the masculine energy is making plans. They did this in the past and they weren't able to. The timing wasn't right in the past. There looks as though there's a misunderstanding that needs to be cleared up, because the Five of Cups is the energy of Scorpio, and we get this Pisces energy of confusion here. So we also have now Pisces energy, Eight of Cups. We've got that twice. Why is the Eight of Cups here in this situation? Somebody not investing. Okay. The Moon and the Moon. Okay. So one person didn't think the other one wanted to invest. There was a walking away, but the truth of the matter is that this is a very, very passionate relationship. Look at this, Ten of Cups energy. This is a very intricate love story. Look at this, Ace of Coins reversed. Somebody rescinded an offer. It looks like there was a very happy, passionate relationship that was going on. It looked as though one person didn't think the other was really investing. They thought they had to walk away. It was a misunderstanding. And now we have clarity. Okay, so look at this. When we get the Moon card reversed, we get that all of a sudden there's clarity. And this is Queen of Wands energy. So it's the energy of being fiery and passionate. So strange. The High Priestess is reversed, though. That's usually intuitive energy. Why is the High Priestess reversed? This is a very complex love story. But it looks, yeah, oh man, it looks like there was some sort of really big misunderstanding. That there's one of you that tends to be shyer. There may be an age difference here in this relationship. And it looks as though, it looks as though something just got out of hand. When you look at the Five of Swords, it's like, I want to win at all costs. But neither of you want to win at all costs. And you didn't use your intuition. And it, there's so much confusion here. But it looks like the relationship ended. Virgo, it looks like your partner ended the relationship because they thought you were walking away, that you didn't want to invest. You thought they didn't want to invest. You're confused. They're confused. Everybody's confused. Okay, why is the Three of Wands here with the Nine of Wands? Why is this energy here for Virgo? Oh, look at this. You were supposed to go on a trip or do something together. Again, Leo energy. There was no victory in love between two really good friends. Some ego differences got in the way. Somebody got wounded here. Six of Cups, no reunion. It's been a while. This is a relationship. This is, and somebody should have rushed in, but they didn't rush in. It looks like they should have rushed in right away to clear things up, and they didn't. They thought there was plenty of time. Wow, something closed out without even the intention. And it's almost like you agreed on it because you were confused. I'm getting the King of Swords with the Justice card, the Queen of Swords. So it really looks as though there was just a complete unhinged misunderstanding between two people that really love each other, and you did not talk about it. Nobody wants to lose here. I mean, you don't want to lose, but you don't want to hurt each other. And you both feel wounded by what happened. This is, okay, so let's see what else we have here for this new beginning. Tell us about the new beginning in this love relationship. The Strength card reversed. Oh my gosh. I wonder if you're separated by a distance. This looks like it could be absolutely distance. Where is the new beginning here? Where is the new beginning? The Truth, the Whole Truth, and Nothing But the Truth, the Ace of Swords. How soon will it be? Page of Swords. It's soon. This is Aquarius energy. No, it's Gemini. I'm sorry. It's Gemini energy. There may be a Gemini involved in this. Why is this Eight of Cups here? One person starting a new beginning with you, and yet somebody's walking away. Oh, wow. Look at this. We've got the Nine of Wands with the Two of Cups. So this person doesn't actually walk away. So that's what we're getting. We're getting that this person has fire in their belly. They feel as though they just feel really hurt, like this is the last time. This is what I'm getting, that if this doesn't come together this time, if it doesn't come together soon, I feel as though two soulmates are going to lose track of each other. Let's see, what do we have here? Virgo, what is? This is quite the reading. Eight of Cups, Eight of Cups. All right, so we need to ask Spirit what's going on here. What is going on? Why is this Eight of Cups here? Why is the Eight of Cups here? There's something really radically different about this reading. Rest and rejuvenation. Well, the Eight of Cups is exhaustion. Let's go and see what the wisdom of the Oracle has to say about this relationship. What is going on? Because it looks like you want a reunion. You both love each other dearly. There's been a massive misunderstanding. Cleaning it up. Clean up the misunderstanding. There we go. It's going to happen. Because look at this. One person is still feeling so like abandoned that they feel like they don't even have a choice. They have to walk away. A change is in the wind. Oh, look at how beautiful that is. Isn't that gorgeous? It's a beautiful change. And look at it is happily ever after. Two of Cups. Happily ever after. I mean, this is very significant. All of this Pisces energy. You know, we have Neptune in Pisces right now, and it's very confusing, especially to like Gemini energy. It's confusing to Virgo right now. So that's all about communication. So we have this beautiful changes in the wind. Tell us more, Spirit, about what is happening with this relationship. So it is really, wow, how messy. Oh, honey, I'm so sorry, Virgo, that this has happened, but you are going to clean it up. You're Virgo, right? Treasure Island, you have great clarity on what you want, and look at fork in the road. So it does look like somebody may be leaving a situation in the past because there is a choice that has to be made at this time. You know, you're keeping your own counsel, Virgo, between two worlds. That makes perfect sense. You're definitely between two worlds. So, Virgo, it looks as though you were in a relationship, and I feel as though you met through somebody through work. There's going to be different variations of this story, but I feel as though you've been in a really unhappy relationship in your life. Could be a marriage, just could be a long-term love relationship. You met somebody who was very different. You fell in love with them. Something went wrong with the communication. Your person didn't think you were very invested, or they didn't really think you cared about them. You didn't really do anything to make it clear. And now you're leaving, you're between two worlds. You're leaving something that is not for you behind. Because when we look at this energy, Virgo, you're walking away from something. You're walking away from something here. You want your happily ever after. But we're seeing here that for some of you, or many of you, you may be simply leaving a relationship that was in very bad shape from the past. And when you met your person, this person that you're looking at, the person you came to ask about, you met them, your person feels as though you abandoned them. And I don't think you really did. I just don't think you really made it clear. I don't think you made a very clear-cut decision. Your person felt that they had, they didn't think it was real. And so they left you behind. Oh, boy. Okay, so let's see what the whispers of love say. What do whispers of love say for beautiful Virgos? This is complicated beyond belief. Okay, whispers of love. What's the message? Love makes a difference. Oh, love can help heal past hurts and provides a sense of security, self-worth, and importance. There we go. So it does look like the two of you will get back together. It looks as though this love relationship that both of you were, you know, you sort of thought it was over. You walked away. You missed each other. Let's see. Imagine all unwanted thoughts. Oh, dissolving into light, creating room for new opportunities and possibilities for your life. So it looks like this is a reconciliation that's long overdue. It looks like you've been in separation from someone that you dearly love, and that there's just the communication between the two of you was so muddy. And now you're going to get a chance to talk soon, and it does look like you share your feelings. Let's see what Moonology says about that. We have that new moon in Aquarius, so it would happen right about now, between now and March. Looks like between now and March. Okay, what does Moonology have to tell us about this relationship? A time for healing. There we go. So Virgo, it does look like a past love comes back into your life. A big element of confusion is healed, and it looks like there is a reconciliation between soulmates, lovers. You know, the two of you adore each other. You love each other. You're so well matched at so many levels. All right, Virgo, I'm going to leave it there. Take care. Sending you love. Bye-bye.